own invoice or isn't he? Because he hasn't got the authority to do it, and yet 429 is saying that he is. And so I don't really understand that. If you go on to, well, there's all the amounts that he's paid. So presumably, if he's issued with a PO number for a year, how much is it for the year? Because the total amount for the year is £182,929. So somebody somewhere else have said, Stuart Halliday has a PO number for the year for £185,000. So you have some kind of margin one way or the other. So do we know that? Do we know how much he was allowed to take from Wirral Council through invoicing the services provided? And were those services the same every month? And if they weren't, what was annotated on an invoice every time? And if it, so, because on, if you go further on, if you have a look at the PO numbers, for instance, see, I don't understand all this raising of dummy invoices, because you know, you raise a dummy one, that can lead to, you know, things going awry. So, on the 2nd of January 2018, there's a new supplier form received from Forge House Associates Limited. On the 25th of January, a PO number, order number, 354598 was raised to 72,000. But for what was that for? Was that for over a period of months, not for a year? Was it for 6 months? What services was that for? Because then you're making payments of 15,600 there, 14,820 in March, 10,920 in April, 20,880 in May, and 16,200 in June. And yet, that comes to more or less, well, that comes to 78,420, but the PO was to 72,000, so already we paid him more than the PO number said he should have.
Cathy, I think you've made your position pretty clear here.
Have I?
With quite a lot of detail, yes.
But so, so for me, so, there's, no. So I'm just wondering, was Forge Associates treated differently as a supplier than other suppliers? Because I bet if you had a supplier that invoiced Middlebury Council for £300 a month, you probably wouldn't pay them without a valid PO number, and I doubt very much whether you would raise a dummy PO number. A dummy PO number was raised 363623 for 16,100. I'm assuming it was for July.
Kath, I think you have given us enough information for the office.
Right, okay. But then, on the 28th of August, we raise another PO number, 364286 for 3,350, because they didn't pay the one for, they didn't pay for 16,100 because there wasn't enough in the kitty or, you know, under the PO number. But even then, that still doesn't add up. Somebody's not really looking at things.
I think you really have made your point.
Okay.
You made it very forceful. So I did have Ron. Is it going to be brief, Ron? Because yeah, I think the office is concentrating on just what's on the state.
It's not on the issue around what is changed in the bank accounts. And given that we've had an experience previously in this committee of somebody changing a bank account for all of us, and then having money to pay into their account, this should have gone to a provider. Sure, we put steps in place, but I'd like to see what the verification steps that we put in place around people changing the back end, not just the case of just somebody saying, I'm changing my back end, because that's what happened previously. They had all the relevant details of the original bank account. I've been able to then throw them and use them over into their account. So it wasn't until the bank holder, the account holder said, where's my money, that they realised money.
Maybe
that statement was in all of his reports that is going to come to this committee. And if it is, I will not wait for that report.
Rob, do you confirm in relation to the bank detail text that the proceeding was timed up significantly following the issue that you're alluding to around the year? The details now, there is a secure number that's logged with the council telephone number, which is used to make a call to the provider, to then ask a series of questions, which again are logged in relation to the security password, which must be presented. There's also details asked in relation to the last payment. issues in relation to Mr. Halliday and his ability to actually sort of responsibility for making payments and authorising invoices of payment. He cannot do that. I'll make that very clear. Signing invoices merely to indicate for the benefit of a more senior officer further plan that certain things have been proceeded, that the goods have been provided. That is double checked and then authorised by a senior officer.
It does say in one of those paragraphs 428 or 418 that he had signed off and that he had signed off and had said that he had done the work.
He actually signed a number of invoices to evidence that goods and services have been provided.
He provided.
The services have been provided, but not by him personally.
But by other people.
Yes, indeed.
Which was the issue.
And that's all he's doing, is indicating that yes, we have cancelled
the issue. Well, look, I think this is a pretty hard area so far. And Mark has already made plain that there is a piece of work being done on this. Jeff has made the point that he would like to see it done as expeditiously as possible, and I think that's really the main gist of the last 15 minutes or so of discussion. So, Mark, can you just give us an assurance about how speedily the work can be done?
As I mentioned earlier, Chair, one of the pieces of work on the verification of the VAT has pretty much been completed. I've been doing that this week.